we're focusing on the Democratic Republic of Congo and South Sudan, because these are two countries that have undergone a lot of suffering over the last few years. Recently, we heard also of some war that has once again erupted in the Ituri region in the Congo, of how many people have been forced out of their areas into Uganda. So our prayer today, we trust in God that He will answer the prayer of His children so that peace returns to the Democratic Republic of Congo and South Sudan. South Sudan has gone through a long period of war, and I think turning to God, you know, in prayer is really an important thing at this time. And the conflict in South Sudan has gone on for many years. Peace agreement was signed. South Sudan became an independent country in 2011. 2 years later, you know, it went back to war, and it was more of now a conflict that was as a result of a disagreement, you know, that our leaders had. So for the last 4 years, the people have been displaced. Over 2 million people have been forced out of South Sudan into the neighboring countries as refugees. Another 2 million people have been displaced as internally displaced persons. I'm reminded of this saying which we have in Africa, that when two elephants fight, it is a grass that is hurt, that suffers most. Last year, the Archbishop of Canterbury visited the refugees in Uganda. I went with him, and visiting, you know, looking at some of the people, in particular some of the clergy that I worked with. And one particular case is my former chaplain, where he was living in a place that he called his house, a few meters square, kind of a structure with a polythene, cover over that roof, which he considered his house. It was heartbreaking to see, you know, a person of that caliber reduced to such suffering. Apart from that, what would you consider as schools, would really as structures, or actually no structures, but some trees. And they said, is it something to do with the lack of vision that our leaders have? As religious leaders, we have appealed to our leaders to put the need of the people of South Sudan as a priority. And
so as individuals, it's easy to feel powerless in the face of such enormous difficulty and suffering on the other side of the world. What on earth can we do to help?
Well, on this day, as we pray, let's indeed pray. I think that's really an important thing. But also let us encourage messages of support would encourage the people. Some of the people that I found who have a lot of hope are religious leaders, Christian leaders, and other faith leaders in South Sudan. But because the suffering has gone on for a long time, in my recent visit, you could see that even for them, they are losing hope. And so I think this call for prayer would also encourage them, give them some encouragement that yes, there is a God that who would hear our prayer and hopefully encourage them to continue soldiering on. Well, I was a bishop in South Sudan, the Diocese of Kajukeji. I was a bishop there for 9 years, and so served the people there. When South Sudan became an independent country, we were all very, very happy, joyful that at long last we would see the country grow and develop. South Sudan, before independence, is a country that had gone through a lot of suffering. And so, yes, it has been a difficult thing for us. But as a Christian leader, we do have a hope in a God who do His own work. He answers prayer. And so today, indeed, is an important day. I believe that out of this, something good will come out of this. Reconciliation is an important aspect of this, because, and reconciliation at grassroots level, I strongly believe that that really is what is key in South Sudan. And by standing in solidarity with the leaders, church leaders, would be a good thing to do.
And do you really believe if we all do this, it can make a difference?
I believe that if we all do this, it will make a lot of difference, because we serve a God who not only hears prayers, but He answers prayers.